Hey, what's up, my lovely viewers? Welcome to episode 7 of Fury Unleashed. So, let's play solo. And I farmed a bit off screen, which means we can upgrade our hero in further. So, I got 3 skill points at the moment. And I'll add those to invulnerability. And the next one we are getting is probably more health drops. Should help out quite a bit. So without further ado, let's get into the game. And yeah, it's getting grindy, I'm not gonna lie. It's really getting grindy. We have to level up a couple of times and spend our points to make some more progression. Alien shard launcher, holy moly. Effective range low. I never used this before. Okay, the range. Range doesn't seem very low to me. Seems like it got a lot of range actually. Okay, that's odd. Range also shouldn't matter too much because we are fighting most enemies at small distances. Like this is when I shot the skeleton guy over there, that was pretty much maximum range, this fight. Enemies aren't further away than one screen and I can easily shoot from one end to the other. So everything is okay and under control. Which makes me second guess the weapon descriptions because previously I... Oh, this is a dead end. Oh, didn't mean to throw a grenade. Because I avoided some weapons which had short range in the description, and as it turns out, the description is sometimes not correct. So, oh, interesting. But this weapon feels very potent. It's basically a straight upgrade over the SMG. Over the starting weapon SMG. Okay, let's try this course. I never cleared this before. Not even on my own, but now I at least know that you don't get permanent damage if you try to clear this. Whoop. Okay, I have to wait for this to go down. Oh no. Oh no, I screwed up. I screwed up massively. Let me check my audio levels real quick. The game seems to be very loud for some reason. No, it's okay, it's low. Oh, strange. Okay. My apologies for that. I should sort stuff like that out before recording. But it seemed like the game audio is way louder than my voice, which I don't like. And if that's the case, I have to fix it right away. Increases ink drop amount while on low health. I don't plan to go on low health, to be completely honest. Well, who does, huh? Like, the plan is always to stay at high health. Oh, got a customer. He got owned. We got 4 HP back. Yeah, it's probably crucial to maximize the HP gain. That's odd, I shot through him. Well, I guess one downside of this weapon is the slow projectile speed. Like, the projectiles could really be a bit quicker. But then it would probably be OP, if You get everything, rate of fire, damage, and... and fast projectiles. Or use another weapon, huh? In that case. I also unlocked a weapon. I unlocked the blaster class. So now I have a blaster, assault rifle, thingy-magic, very sci-fi. I played with it once so far. And seems to be also a potent weapon. Which of course I expected, because if you unlock a weapon you want it to be an upgrade, or at least a side grade to an existing weapon. Why else would you use it? And why would you even add it to the game in the first place if it's not an upgrade, side grade? Doesn't make sense to add a weapon which is worse in every aspect. So, chapter 2, what's his deal now? One target will be marked on your map. Get there quickly and kill the enemy with a melee weapon to receive a reward. Time is limited to 20 seconds, but every melee kill extends the timer by... Oh, I'm not gonna do that. That's a recipe for disaster. Probably, at least for me. This is a very bad arena for me to fight this guy. Like, you don't want an arena where you can't kite him around. Okay, he's down. But he hit me a couple of times. Way too much for my liking. I should have used my special ability. What am I doing? Should have pressed F. Because he hit me like 3 times, I believe. Like, this arena is so bad. The spikes on top and that saw in the bottom. That's really an unfortunate arena. Very bad room to fight him. Like, I would have been... Probably I would have been fine against him. Against another enemy. I'm the Blade Master once again. So what does he want this time? Finish off the next 5 enemies with your melee weapon. I can do that. I can do... Oh. Just as I said, I can do it. Oh no. Oh no. I completely spaced out immediately. I was like, oh, I'm gonna shoot that enemy. Seems like a good idea. Why not? Well, because you have to use your melee weapon, dummy. Ah, I can't believe it. Oh, that's so funny. Way I immediately jinxed that. absorb the cluster grenade. Because we don't need it. Okay. He didn't drop health. Unfortunately. Okay, whoop. So what's over here? Oh. Okay, to kill that guy. Jesus Christ. This was one nasty room. A very nasty room. Okay, let's traverse this room. Okay, cool. Also, if I'm successful, this will be the 3rd week of daily uploads on my YouTube channel, which makes me very proud. Like, that's what I was aiming for, what I was hoping for. Crap, I have to kill these guys in melee. In melee? Melee? Whatever. However you pronounce it. I'm gonna go with melee. Melee Island from Monkey Island. famously, of course. Okay. I'm not 100% sure what that guy's deal is. Like that cursed treasure chest which just tried to kill us. Oh, which tried to kill me. I'm still on the fence if I should use plural or singular form when I refer to the gameplay. Because I feel like it's probably a journey as a viewer and you want to get involved and you want to be a part of it. I'm gonna die here. If I keep taking hits like that, I'm surely gonna die. Let's not do that. How about that? Okay, let's use a grenade on him. Let's actually hit him with a grenade. That only took 3 tries. Yes, a viewer, you probably want to get involved. You probably want to, well, be part of the whole journey. We have still 1 skill point, which is unused. Oh yeah, we have 1. But I want to get at least 2. And all 3 for this. Like, both of these are fine. I want to max out on health, basically. Combo shield could also be a really good one to max. Holy moly, I need a lot of here. There's a lot of stuff in here that's really useful. Like, whoever designed this did a really good job, because most of the perks are really useful. I want to get them. So anyways, let's start another run. And yeah, this game is getting grindy, but I don't know. Maybe I'll have to play it more off screen and grind stuff. So that we can have... Oh, why did I go with the SMG? I need to change my loadout before the next run. Assault rifle, oh baby, here we go. Oh, this gun feels nice. Feels potent. It's really satisfying to shoot. Projectiles are fast. Nice, I like it. I like it a lot. It's an AK, right? Looks like an AK. I'm gonna refer to it as the AK. Like, that's... To me, that's an assault rifle, an AK. Or the assault rifle I think of it. Duration 8, increases shooting and reloading speed by 50, increases critical chance. So it gives an insane amount of damage, basically. I think I'll stick with the eyes, because damage isn't really the problem. I can kill every boss. The issue is, however, that I get hit and take damage. So, and freezing, or the freezing ability, is probably more helpful to me. I can see how the other ability would be powerful if you're actually good at the game. It's definitely a powerful one, sounds at least powerful. I have a big combo going. Oh, this bug is an elite. I murdered him. Yeah, potion drop chance increase is also another really, really useful perk. At least it sounds very useful. Let's use a grenade on those guys. Oh, come on, don't screw it up now. Okay, I have to parkour a bit. Wow, we are having a huge combo right now. Okay, let's shoot him. Holy moly. Wow, the music gets intense. I'll stop talking just for the music. Okay, enough of the music. Oh wow. Okay, I have to murder this guy. What is he anyways? He looks like a scuffed ink master. Oh wow, 43. Holy, this is the combo of the century. Skull Mace, oh baby, that looks badass. Oh, here we go. Now we're going places. Oh, I lost the combo. But 49? That's a really high combo. Cluster grenade, sure. Give it to me. So ink is basically like XP, and you level your character with it. And for the character levels you get experience points. I don't know if that's the ideal system for that. The ideal progression system, meta progression, that is. I feel like, oops, eventually you could have gotten away with the just, oh well, it's hard, it's probably hard to come up with an exact amount of EXP. It's better to do it in like a token system like this one. Okay, I'm murdering guys. The assault rifle, really potent weapon. Really potent weapon as it turns out. Oh, I can... Oh! I can pierce his shield. Oh, that's new. That's probably courtesy of the assault rifle. Ah, oh, excuse me. Had a lump in my throat. Or a bit. That's probably courtesy of the assault rifle. Because I know the SMG can't pierce the shield. Like, you have to get into melee range with him and kill him that way. That I know for sure. But I didn't know you could... I was under the impression the shield would stop all projectiles. Oh. That was sloppy. Vlad the Peaceful. Yeah. No, I'm not gonna lose HP for a weapon or some equipment. Nope. Wow, that guy exploded in my face. And yeah, I said that. That was an actual sentence I said. Oh, that one is gonna be in the comments, huh? A guy came on my face. It's a sexual reference. That's so funny, Mr. YouTuber. Okay. Oh. That was weird. I was out of ammo for a moment. Oh wow. Here comes the boss. Not the boss, but the champion. Okay. He is no problem. Get wrecked, mate. Legendary impulse shotgun. Legendary sticky bomb launcher. Legendary blaster. No, it's just a rare one. Yeah, I don't have cash for any of these. Well, I could get a downgrade here, yeah, but why would I? Maybe I'm just a dummy. Maybe the trick was to shoot him when he is shooting all along. To initiate some kind of counterattack. Okay, I need to get up to there. Surprise, yeah, okay. I can't pierce his shield, I'm not going insane. It's just that when he shoots, you can hurt him. I get it. I have a surprise for you, yeah, sure. Well, this reduces damage taken by 5%. Let's absorb this one. Even though the armor would be nice, probably. Okay, this is going to be a tough one. Maybe not. Maybe not. Maybe I spoke too soon. Oh. Well, these guys are the scariest. When they pop up all of a sudden and try to murder you. That's the scariest moment. Man, and I published a video today which is doing really great, like 5 views straight off the bat in a couple of hours, which is huge for my channel. And it was a Fury Unleashed episode, one of those that I'm recording right now. Well, I'm recording one of those right now, so that way around it makes sense. Okay, this is a different variant of the other spider boss. Okay. Oh wow. This guy is unpleasant. This is much harder than... Oh Jesus, absorb. Jesus, that was a tough fight. Holy moly, that variant of the boss is way tougher than the other one. Okay, come on, open your shield. Trouble. Oh, the invulnerability saved me there. Otherwise, I would have lost my remaining bit of HP. 5 HP. Well, 10 HP now. Yay, that's gonna make a difference. Most likely not. Max combo 49. That was insane. That was really a lot. And oh, look where it is. Oh wow, two of these guys, really, and I'm on low HP. Oh, how did I even survive that? I got hit for 10 and yeah, but that was stupid to melee that guy. We are going to spend the points in next episode. And yeah, I'll end the video right here. Like, 2 runs per video is a good amount in my opinion. I want to keep these videos between 20 to 30 minutes. I don't want to produce a super long video. Yeah, content might get a bit repetitive. I'll do most grinding probably off screen. But yeah, the goal is to beat the boss a couple more times and unlock the second comic book permanently. As always, thanks for watching. I really appreciate all the views, especially for this series. It's like the main workhorse of the channel right now. It's gotta be said. Yeah, thanks for that. Thanks for the support. And I'll see you guys with another episode of Fury Unleashed soon. Until then, Cookie out and bye!